What exactly is the nature of the space that a painter makes on a canvas? Where is it in relation to the kind of space we understand that may be looked out on from a high point or enclosed within four walls? When painters make space, are they increasing, adding to the amount of space that already exists in the world? Or are they making another space altogether, one that doesn't relate to what is already there? It can't be quite like the space reflected in a mirror, because that is just what it is called, mirror image, an illusion, and doesn't really add anything to the world. And not like the space that Moses made when he parted the waves, because presumably the water just piled up higher on either side, liberating the path between. In many cases, the space created by a painter seems strangely infinite, more than when one is gazing at the stars or at the horizon, or at a photograph of the Earth taken from the moon. Where is that space, and what is it pointing to? Is it pointing as much back to us as outwards? And if it is, where is that space? Of course, when you look at a painting in which the space seems particularly assertive, say Pierrot's Flagellation, or one of Matisse's Morocco paintings, we know it is an illusion on a flat surface. But for those moments when our disbelief is suspended, it is more than an illusion. It's a journey. We are transported somewhere. Does that occur in our vision, in our heads or hearts, or out there somewhere in another space altogether? Or at some special meeting place between the two? But wherever it is, it must surely add to the sum total of the space that exists in our world.